Now, Storm Tracker weather with East Idaho's chief meteorologist, Doug Iverson.
There's Yellowstone, and then there's us. Yeah, look how socked in we are, all the way up to the Montana border, and then even west into the portions of the Magic Valley. That's that stratus layer that's over the top of us. It will lower, and once it touches the ground, then we got fog out there. Already getting reports of fog in a few spots, and it will be thick, too, later tonight. So be careful if you're driving. When we get freezing fog during the wintertime, or any time of year, if it's freezing, it will create icy roadways out there. So you'll be going along thinking, hey, well, at least the roads are dry. They may not necessarily be dry. Definitely slick. So be careful. Give yourself extra time to work or school, or if you're going to be traveling this evening, certainly give yourself a few extra minutes to your destination. 19 in Idle Falls, 21 in West Yellowstone. You get above that inversion up higher where it's actually warmer. That's the problem. Warmer air trapping a layer of cool, moist air down low. Higher elevations gets above that inversion and they're warmer. At 27 degrees in Jackson right now. Salt Lake City, they deal with an inversion this time of year. They're at least above freezing for the moment. Logan, only 23 degrees, and inversion two over in the Boise area. It seems like they've invented this stuff over there in the Treasure Valley during the wintertime. So freezing fog advisory until 8 o'clock tomorrow morning for the Snake River Plain. Still pretty cold out there. Lows in the upper Snake will be in the single digits for some. 14 for a low temperature in Pocatello. Now we have fog for some for the Central Mountains. Salmon, you've been socked in with low clouds and some fog as well, so you're going to see that again all night long. That'll keep you from being colder than a lot of us. That means you'll stay out of those single digits, unlike Stanley, where we're looking at a low of 4. Now, for the highlands in western Wyoming, mostly clear, and look at how cold it will be. Afton, the Goose Egg tonight, Island Park will have a low of 1 above, and then tomorrow, lots of sunshine, so head back up to Yellowstone if you want, 29 there. How warm it's going to be in Jackson, actually above freezing, 34. Even Island Park, not too bad at 28. Driggs above freezing. Soda Springs above freezing with a high of 33. Now, for the Central Mountains, wouldn't be surprised if we see some fog, low clouds in the morning, especially in the Salmon area. We had some fog this morning in Challis, and there's a possibility that tomorrow morning temperatures will rise above freezing, though, for most places. 38 in Leadville, or a warm spot there. Stanley in mid-30s. Partly sunny for the Snake River Plain. Certainly some fog in the morning, but I think we'll get a little more sunshine than what we saw today. Temperatures, therefore, will be a bit warmer. Still freezing cold all day long. 7-day forecast as we look ahead. We got a little more sunshine as we get into the weekend. That means a little warmer. And look at what's waiting for us on Monday. All of next week, speaking of warmer, we'll take those 40s. Yeah, we don't want to give those up. Idle Falls 7-day forecast. A little less fog through the weekend. Fewer clouds, more sunshine. Sunday finally above freezing. And we'll hit 40 on Tuesday. That will feel like the banana belt around here. Now, for the Teton area, we got temperatures warming up into the 30s. We'll stay in the 30s all weekend, with highs Monday and Tuesday in the 40s. Wow. Now, for the Central Mountains, wait a minute, we just had snow, right? Central Mountains, look at all that sunshine. 40s for 4 days in a row. That won't happen until Monday. Lows will mainly be in the teens.